Hi, and welcome to ISPI. Today, I'm going to experiment with a new accessory for the all-in-one router base. Because of an upcoming shelf project, I had this idea of an accessory that allows me to make precise and repeatable dados and rabbits. Therefore, I take out the fine adjust spindle and cut off a longer one, which I attach later. For this new accessory, I use two aluminum angles. I cut them to length and make some cutouts, so they will fit over the T-tracks and the spindle supports. Here I mark the positions of the cutouts for the T-tracks. Then I cut them on the table saw. Next, I clean all the edges with a file and mark and make the cutouts for the spindle supports. Then I take out the two parts to which the aluminum angles will be attached to. I clamp the aluminum angles to these parts so I can drill the holes through both parts. To attach the angles to the router base parts, I will use countersunk screws. Therefore, I cut threads directly into the wood. Then I reassemble the router base and add the new longer spindle. Next, I attach the angles to see how they fit. Here you can see that the angles protrude at the bottom of the base. The idea is that I have two edge guides that can be adjusted depending on the size of dado I will make. Because of a reason which you will see later, I decided to cut off one end of each angle. For demonstration, I make a classical task. A board for a shelf which has a rabbet on either end and some dados in between. So I mark the positions of the dados. Actually, I just have to mark the first dado, but I mark every position to check if the workpiece has the right length. I mark the second dado with a longer pencil line, because this is the first dado I will cut. This is because the router base cannot make dados that are closer to the edge. But there is a trick to make dados which are half this distance to the edge. You will understand later. I use a slightly smaller router bit than the width of the board which will be the dado for. So I can make every size of dado without the need to have for each board the right bit. But it will also work with the right size bit. First, I set the depth of the router bit. Then I place the board in between the two adjusting parts of the base and clamp it by turning the adjustment knob. I fix this position by fastening the wing nuts underneath. Next, I attach the original edge guide and set it so that the router bit just touches the ruler. Because of the fact that I used a board with the right thickness to obtain this gap, I just have to close the gap and the edge guide will be in the perfect position for the rabbet on either side of the board. First, I make the rabbet on either side. Actually, it's not a rabbet because I use a smaller router bit, but I will route the leftover edge later. Then I attach the aluminum angles to the router base. Next, I have to set the angles so they will fit in the already made groove. I could do that directly on the workpiece, but I made a template of the groove, which is easier to use to set the angles in the right distance. I fix this position with the wing nuts as before. I set the router bit at the height of the base plate and adjust the router bit to the pencil line on the workpiece. I just shift the board the router is attached to. Next, I set the router bit to the depth of the already made groove. And then it's time to make the dados. It's relatively easy to guide the router, because the aluminum angles will slide in the groove on the edge. Then I can make the second dado with the help of the first one. Unfortunately, I forgot to change the camera angle, but it's the same process as before. Then I turn the workpiece to make the remaining dados from the other side. And this is the trick that I mentioned earlier in the video. By making a shelf that has an odd number of compartments and routing from the other side, the remaining dados will be right in between the dados which are made from the opposite side. All the dados are made, but not with the right width, so the board don't fit in yet. To make the dados wider, I first cut away the leftover at the edge to complete the rabbit. To make the dados the right size, I have to adjust the gap between the aluminum guides. I do that by clamping the board, which should fit in the dado, in between the adjusting parts of the router base. And here is why I shortened the aluminum angles earlier. The adjustment of the gap works only if I can clamp the board between the wooden part of the gap. If I hadn't shortened the angles, I had no access to a wooden area of the gap. If that makes sense. With this adjustment of the gap, the router bit will cut the dado to the perfect size, and the aluminum guides will fit perfectly in the wider dados. To widen the first dado, I have to slide the aluminum guide along the edge of the rabbit, and then I can use the first dado to slide the guides in it. The rest of the process is the same as before. In the video I widen the two first dados from each side before I finish the remaining dados. And here is the result of this experiment. Two of the dados are perfect and two of them are a bit too loose. But I'm very happy with the result, if you consider that it was just an experiment. Also, the rabbits on the edge are perfect. I think the reason why two of the dados are too wide is that the angles are too weak. So I will order angles with a thicker wall thickness and exchange them. But all in all, I call it a success. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!